1998, on Golden Acres Stud Farm, a star was born. When the dam, Carne de Dance, gave birth here in this humble stable to the filly, Ippy Tombi.
Becoming an eventual, Ippy Tombi takes the lead. 100 metres left to go. It's Ippy Tombi in front, drawing clear of Paolini. And Ippy Tombi beat
Ippy Tombi is clear, and she's going to win it for Zimbabwe. Ippy Tombi wins by 3 from Special Parade. Then
Jay Williams on the bicycle.
First time out, Ippy Tombi easily broke her maiden at Borrowdale Park. She showed she was something special when she again won her second start in facile fashion.
It's still Ippy Tombi, Captain Cash trying to rally late, but Ippy Tombi, she's a good filly. She wins a fight, 2 and a bit.
6 months later, with 4 wins under her belt, she took her first feature in South Africa, the SA Fillies Classic at Newmarket.
But Ippy Tombi is clear, and she's going to win it for Zimbabwe. Ippy Tombi wins by 3.
From then on, she remained unbeaten. In 2002, Ippy Tombi took the Durban July Handicap.
Key of Destiny, Angus is getting closer. Ippy Tombi's flying from nowhere. Key of Destiny, Ippy Tombi, Ippy Tombi.
That was a surreal moment. I had Ippy Tombi from the start of her career until she left for South Africa. To see that little filly come, yeah, it was awesome. Very emotional, but very special. Special for the country, special for so many people who really needed something to hold on to at that time.
In February 2003, Ippy Tombi hit the world stage in Dubai.
But this classy mare is much too good. Ippy Tombi holding Royal Trist at bay. The post comes up and the mare wins by 2 lengths.
With her first international win, there was no stopping Ippy Tombi. Taking on the world, her second international victory in the Dubai Duty Free Stakes on the 29th of March 2003 became the highlight of her illustrious career. In Dubai, the little bay filly Ippy Tombi, once more showing enormous courage, went down in history as the greatest Zimbabwean export to grace the world stage, and one of the greatest horses out of Africa.
Eventual in front, Ippy Tombi coming in Eventual. Ippy Tombi takes the lead, 100 metres left to go. It's Ippy Tombi in front, drawing clear of Paolini. And Ippy Tombi beats Paolini, Royal
out the way, and away they go. Quick into stride is Brianna together with Jet Mirage. On the far side we find Wantage, and Holy Land's been taken to the back of the field. So Morgan Yamagwete likes to lead on Brianna. This is what she does best. She's got that weight advantage, and she goes out to a 2.5 length lead from back in second, Jet Mirage hard held. Third place belongs to Wantage, and Holy Land will see all his dangers. He's some 5 lengths off them. So it's Brianna making her way past the Stives Tower, leads by a length and a half. Back in second we've got Jet Mirage. On his outside we find Wantage. Brewer's got Holy Land in last position, some 6 lengths off them. So can Morgan Yamagwete slow them up here on board Brianna? They haven't left her alone as Wantage now moves up. Back in second there we've got Brianna. On his own side there we find Jet Mirage, and Holy Land's got 5 to go. They're going to swing right-handed just now, and then Brianna find another gear. She leads by a length. Back in second is Wantage. Jet Mirage has been given a perfect ride. He's in third. Holy Land starting to rev up the gears. It's Brianna. She's got a 2 length lead from back in second, Jet Mirage. Wantage comes up to join them. Jet Mirage switches in again as Brianna finds another gear. Jet Mirage is holding on for second. Wantage down the middle of the course, and on the and then Holy Land's got 4 to go. It's still Brianna. Back in second, Jet Mirage is coming through smartly now. It's Jet Mirage who picks it up from Brianna, and it's Seister's day today at Borrowdale Park. Well done to Jeffrey. He's earned another winner for Deborah. Swanson. Second will go to Brianna. Third will go to Holy Land. And fourth will go to Wantage.
Yeah, this horse has been very, very genuine, and he's done very well on Zim. Another one who came as a battle two-time winner, and he's found his niche, and he's made us very proud and given us a lot of fun in racing. So very, very proud of him. Jeffy rode him perfectly. We had a few niggles his last time out. Everyone was wondering what happened to him, but the race didn't pan out the way he needed it to run, and we learned from that, and he's come back today, and Jeffy's learned from the errors in the past, and he's got him right over there. He doesn't get a stride past mile, but he's done it well today, and it was a lovely little feature to win. Very special to win the Epitombi. She was a very special horse, and we all hold her in her high regard. And Jackie and Gary Jolliffe, who did so much work with her, they're good friends of Zimbabwean racing. So I hope they've managed to watch this race. I was hoping that they would come, but I don't think they've made it. But yeah, we all hold Epitombi in very, very high regard. So it's very, very special, and I'm very privileged to win this little feature race with her, with Jet Mirage. And he's been a brilliant horse. He's gone up high in the merit ratings, but we won his races, so we can't complain. And every win now is a bonus, so this is great. Thank you. Thank you to his owners. They are a great bunch of people to train for. They really are a pleasure to train for. They have a lot of fun with their horses, and I hope that they continue to have as much fun in racing.
Well, Auntie Deborah, please stand by for the presentation. I want to talk to Jeff. Yeah, well done to you, Jeff, for getting the feature event with the Jet Mirage. Take us through the race.
Yeah, actually a very good race. He was settled nicely. The pace was good. I had to switch to the inside. I didn't want to really take a gap, but once he got his feet together and he quickened up nicely, once he hit the front, it's hard to catch him. So very well done to Debbie for getting him in top shape. And I think the mile will be his furthest from here, 14:50 sprint races. That'll be him. I hope he can win more big races because he's really a lovely horse.
Well done to you. Please stand by for the presentation.
Thank you very much. I'd like to thank David again for all the opportunities to the owners. And it's been a good day. We had 4 winners. Very chuffed. Hopefully it may continue. And God bless. Thank you.
Can we have the connections for the two? I grant well done to you winning the feature event.
Thanks very much. I mean, we had a hell of a chance. We weren't in at the weight, but Debs gave us confidence. Jeffrey Seister's been a great jockey to us. Our one partner is in South Africa at the moment. We've got a horse running in Scottsville just now. We're very privileged and very thankful for this. And thank you very much to the sponsors. Without that, racing always battles here. So we appreciate any sponsorship we can get. And we've got a great turnout upstairs. So the guys, just think about this. Keep it going. And that's what we're here for.
Well done, guys.
Thank you very much.
Please stand by for the presentation, and you can come through, guys, and get the presentation for the trophy. The MWS Epitombi Stakes over 1,600 meters, won by the 2 Jet Mirage. Second went to horse number 4, Brianna. Third to the 1 Holy Land, and fourth to the 3 Wantage. That concludes racing here at Borough Park. We'll see you in 2 weeks' time.